Greetings, it is I, Shepherd Chong, bringing to you more Dark Souls. So, in the last episode, I beat Seath the Scaleless, and unfortunately I didn't get the Moonlight Greatsword, but, you know, whatever. It's unfortunate, but, So, in this episode, I'm going to try to complete Sigmire's questline, and then I intend to try to beat Bed of Chaos. First, I have to get down there. Which is always a bit of a pain in the ass. Because it can't warp anywhere near it.
Huh. That did not do nearly as much fall damage as I expected it to. Okay. Not as much of a pain in the ass as I expected it to be. Okay.
Well, that's unfortunate. What was that? I saw a health bar with damage. The hell was that about?
What's that?
You know what? Fuck it. Okay. So maybe this is where Sigmire is. Definitely don't want to fall at the moment. Oh, there he is. Anything I can do in this area? Yeah, this is definitely a path that I'm on at the moment. Okay. Hmm. Let's see. Items and stuff. What do I got? There's some stairs over here. Where do they go? Okay, there's an item over there. Alright. For the moment, I'm not gonna fight that thing. Because I know something about the quest. I don't know if that's a part of it. Of course, it has to do with fighting enemies. Let's see.
Talk. Sleep standing up again. For completing your quest. Yes, the time has come. You have to go down there. We both have to live.
To that effect, I think there's, that area might be full of water. So let's go ahead and do that.
Okay. That will kill you. I hope I don't fail. Shit. Well, fuck. So much for that quest line.
Yeah, you come over here, you piece of shit. Damn it. I mean, yes, the reward is a slab, and I don't really need slabs. But I wanted to freaking do it, you know? How do I get out of here? No, but seriously, how do I get out of here? Over here? Okay, yes. That's how I get out of here then. So what about this way then? Uh-huh. Well, there might be stuff over here. Doesn't appear to be much of anything over here. Didn't I just see a hole in the roof? I did. Let's see here. There is no way to tell. It is not a mimic. Red titanite slab, okay. Where is that? All right. Pretty annoyed about me failing this quest. But, you know, whatever. Let's see. And I'm guessing this route is the way out. No, it is not. Oh, come on. Oh, come on. Do I seriously have to go back in there to get out? God damn it, I do. Annoying. The route to get out. Now I'm out again, and now it's time to go fight the Bed of Chaos and probably die. Because that's just what the Bed of Chaos is like. Hopefully I'll be able to beat the Bed of Chaos this episode. I mean, I'm only like 20 minutes in.
If you want to look at the Bed of Chaos, we'll get some cutscenes soon. Yep, cutscene. Here is the Bed of Chaos. It's a bunch of branches. A fiery thing. Interesting noise it makes, though. Okay, so it looks like I gotta go this way. Possibly. No? Maybe not. That was close. Nope. Well, didn't really think I would do it the first try.
Back to the boss fight. Puzzle boss fight.
Well, I'm not really losing anything. There it was again. Something that looked like a life bar with damage being taken.
Where am I supposed to? Son of a bitch.
Okay. And now it's just the third one left. Which is, of course, the hardest. So now the boss has more attacks. Not yet. Heal. For the most disappointing aspect of this really hard boss. That was the real boss right there. The little bug. Achievement complete, kill bed of chaos. Humanity. Souls. What was that? Oh, bonfire. Yep. That was the boss. One of the great founders of this world. A bug.
So, I'm halfway through this recording. Let me think. Wish there was some way to store souls. I could really use those 72,000 after I beat the DLC. For part of the DLC, so I can get, I need, what is that, 15,000? I have, some soul items. It's been a while since I repaired the equipment. So I did look up at a map, and I did figure out how to get to those couple of items that are still here in the Crystal Cave. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. So I'm genuinely kind of annoyed with this one. So this looks sort of like it's a path. It's a path. It was that easy. Damn it, all of that is annoying. Now, this invisible path is going to be the most difficult one of them all. Because unlike the others, it is not a straight line. Oh shit. Oh! Well, that's unexpected. There's basically no way to tell where anything is.
See? Like that.
There was no way to tell that was there. Really annoying. Still, there were three crystal lizards under there. I have no idea. Well, there's my, souls. Oh, hey, look at that! This is the same path! Huh! Look at that! Now, see, that is a trick right there. Alright. Blue Titanite Slab. That means I can do one of the magic paths all the way to whatever the top thing is. 15, 10, whatever. And I really don't feel like going back that way. So I'm just gonna use a homeward bone. So, what is left at this point? Oh gee, another what's left. Well, thankfully, there isn't a whole lot left. There's beating Priscilla, there's beating Gwendolyn, which I am saving for the, like, episode before last, possibly, because of the way their mechanics work. There's Neo, which is probably gonna happen next episode. And then there's the DLC, which I have somewhat started on. And maybe item collection? Soul farming? That I'm not gonna be doing on screen? I think that's pretty much it. Yeah. Alright. So, Neo. It's real Neo. That's fine for the moment, because warping to the Tomb of the Giants puts me at the first one, and I need to be at the second one. Which I haven't been to in for freaking ever, so I don't actually quite remember where everything is. Fun! Alright, let's see. This direction. There's Patches. They won't become my merchant at Firelink Shrine until after I beat Neo. Where are enemies? I need to go this way. Right, because there's the bonfire. Forward is down there. And over here is the bonfire. Yeah, okay. Alright. What to do, what to do, what to do? I feel like... Well, there's like 10 minutes before that I've been recording for an hour. So... probably just gonna do a little bit of inventory management before I kill off. Yeah, sure, why not?
This does do divine damage, which could be useful against the minions Neo summons. This will kill him permanently because he counts as a necromancer.
Just to make sure, repair equipment. Yep, everything is done and ready for the boss fight against Neo. So I'm gonna spam this fight as much as possible until I'm beaten. Then it's on to the DLC, possibly. Might go into Kiln or whatever it is before I do the DLC, just farm some Black Knights. But yeah, I am Shepherd Chong, and this was more Dark Souls. Goodbye. hug face.